Here we have a Cleveland sage, and it's planted right next to tomatoes, bell peppers, artichoke, a citrus tree. And the reason why these all work so well together is because the native plants, the sage and the others around, bring in the native pollinators that help you get a higher yield on your edibles. And then when the birds are here to eat the insects on the native plants, they'll also get the insects that could be on your other food-bearing plants. Cleveland sage likes well-draining soil. And as you can see, it gets about 5 feet tall and about 6 feet wide. So what you do with this sage in the fall, after all the seeds have been eaten out of the old flower husks, is you would prune it back down to where leaves begin toward the tip of the stem. So leave the old seed husks on for food for birds, and then prune it back in the fall.